Hello, Michael Zalapsky here for Make It Monday. So grab your coffee and get ready. Today, we're going to be looking at Supercomp. I'll be taking you from basically this to basically this. Zero to hero, or zero to villain, I guess. And it's easy. Let's go. All right. We've got our forest footage here. Nice little subtle camera move there. We've got the 3D camera tracker because we've tracked this shot into the scene. We've got a portal and some wings that are going behind our lady, and they're all 3D tracked into the scene. Now, you'll notice that none of their 3D layer switches are turned on because Supercomp doesn't work with 3D layers. So if you pre-compose any 3D layer and then tick this collapse a transformation switch, it'll let your camera in your main scene drive its position and everything just as if it were, you know, a 3D layer, but it delivers a 2D layer to Supercomp, which means it works. And then we've also got this little displacement layer here, which is using the circle effect, fractal noise, and turbulent displace to kind of animate and give you this little organic motion here, and solid composite to fill everything in black. All right, so let's make this all look like it goes together. Effect, Red Giant VFX Supercomp. So you'll notice, first of all, we got the Supercomp panel pops up. There's a black layer over top of everything that has the Supercomp effect on it. Open panel, pops this open. We'll dock the panel right in here, so it's kind of easier to see what we're doing. And let's turn off everything and focus on just our background for now. I'm gonna make it more fantasy looking, so I'm gonna use the color correction effect that's built into Supercomp. And I'm going to say, hey, I want the bright areas to be a lot darker, and maybe add kind of a greenish tinge to them. Brighten up the shadows and the midtones a lot. Shadows a little bit, midtones a lot, and definitely pull the shadows into like a blue area to give this kind of a real nice, deep fantasy feeling. All right, that's looking pretty good. And here's our lady. Now she's looking like she doesn't belong in this scene at all now, especially we've colored the background. So let's make her black levels and white levels match first. Instead of having to tweak all these wheels to make things match up, we can just hit match background. But the problem is, our lady is sitting over this, so it's going to give her black levels and white levels that match. But she's supposed to be kind of sitting more here in Z space, like a lot closer to the camera. So I'm just going to put her over that section and hit match background. See, she looks much better there versus if I'd hit it when it's up there and it really fades her out. All right, so we'll put her right here, match background, and control home to put her back where she belongs. Some other effects that'll help sit her into the scene. I'm going to use the edge blend effect. If I turn it way up, you'll kind of see what it's doing. It's taking the background layers, multiple background layers will work, like even the wings will come through and affect it. And it's blurring it with the front layer. There's a lot more than just simply blurring the alpha. I'm just gonna use that on 0.5 though, just to give that edge just a little bit of a hint. And speaking of the edge, I'm gonna give it a proper light wrap. So you get the light kind of bleeding from the background. And again, it works with all these layers. They say that pink now comes through. Instead of having oodles and oodles of pre-comps to make all your layers work together correctly with light wrap. I'm going to switch to encroachment mode. I like that better. And it just all works. It all works at once. With no problems. And I'm going to add a little bit more haze on her with the haze effect, but I'm going to give her some shadow so it doesn't quite come over all. But there we go. And again, throw this back there and all of those effects now work with all the layers together. Very, very handy. And you know what? I'm going to copy all effects and I'm going to paste them onto the wings here so they can kind of sit in the scene. Now, those wings, I want that red in the wings to kind of more match the orange in her outfit. And so I'm just going to quickly add a hue saturation effect in After Effects. Supercomp, as you can see here, works nicely with After Effects layers, just as if they were native. And I think I'm going to desaturate the wings just a touch. So yeah, Supercomp works, no problem. Go back to the Supercomp panel here. Oh, and you know what, there's one thing I forgot to mention on her fabric here. You see, you can see through because it's got a nice transparency on it and Primatic keyed that out nicely. But look over, you can see her foot behind the fabric. There's kind of a blur to it. And we need this to blur out back here as well. So we'll say, hey, on the layer, lady layer, blur behind. And we'll crank that up quite a bit. And you'll see it just blurs all the footage that is behind the partial alpha there. So turn it off and on, off and on. And you'll see it just does a really good job of coming, giving that a little bit of blurriness to match what happens in real life. We've got her and her wings sitting in the scene a lot more like they belong. And let's add this portal in here. Color correction. And I'm just gonna match background where it is to kind of knock that portal back into the background. I'm going to darken it up some and lose some of the saturation as well. I want to add a little touch of glow to it. So we're going to add some optical glow, crank the amount way down, and the size way up. Less. To kind of have it help it feel like it's got a little more light to it. Now I could set this layer to be like an additive mode. You know what, that works. I'm just going to knock the opacity down just a bit on there. And again, all those layer effects are working together. So if I crank this optical glow amount up, you'll see that it blurs back behind this partial transparency, just like it should. So it's real bright here, dimmed out back behind there. Lovely. Everything's working together very nicely. Supercomp is great. Now, I want to have a little bit of displacement here to help set that in. So I'm going to set this to be an adjustment layer. I'm going to apply the displacement effect to it. Color correction, heat blur, displacement all work nicely to give you localized control over different things. I'm just going to use displacement. I want to pull it in just a touch to make it feel like it's kind of warping out of there. Yeah, there we go. Kind of make everything feel like it's warping into it. And we'll take a softness down. There we go. So we just got that little bit of warpy displacement back there. Now don't sleep on the ability to use magic bullet looks to really help sell a composite. So I'm going to make a new adjustment layer. I'm going to apply magic bullet looks to it. Now magic bullet looks, I use all the time on my CG stuff to make it feel like it was shot on an actual camera. And I'm going to just really quickly click on tools to make them stick out here. I'm going to just throw in a bunch of tools that I tend to use on making a composite. So some optical diffusion, some lens distortion, and maybe some mojo, some clarity, and always a halation and renoiser to make it look like it was shot on film. So optical diffusion has a bunch of settings based on real world lens filters here, and I'm gonna just do pro mist a quarter. Let me turn all the rest of these effects off. So you're just seeing, you know, before and after. Just get a little bit of haze and add it into the scene over everything to help just sell the effect more. So lens distortion, this is a kind of a wide angle lens it was shot with. And I want to help add just a little bit more distortion to it so that when she and everything else here passes through that lens distortion, it'll really all feel like it's all part of the same scene. Some clarity in here to bring back some of the detail that may have gotten covered up by the diffusion. I'll add a little bit of mojo on top of everything. Just to kind of help give it just a little touch before, after, just a little touch of kind of blockbuster punched up. Halation, I like to use some of the presets like Modern 35. Halation is a beautiful effect that happens in actual film, and some renoiser while using some Modern 35 as well. Renoiser rebuilds your image out of film grain. It's a very realistic film grain simulation. So before and after just gets that subtle bit of grain to really help go over everything to make it all feel like it's shot on the same piece of film. So before magic bullet looks and after. So there you go. Some quick compositing tips getting you from pretty much zero to pretty much hero in less than 10 minutes. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to our channel for more tips like this, and of course follow us on social media for a ton more tips every Tuesday and throughout the week.